He would always say, you know, the Jesuits taught him healthy guilt. Be guilty enough to make you be better than you are,
yeah.
Which is healthy guilt. Not guilt that paralyzes you, but guilt that encourages you to be something else. Terry was a wonderful Catholic man in his tastes. He was universal. He could see the good in everybody. And any man that built his life on love, how can you say that they weren't an absolute perfection of what God wants in people? Now, whether churches or society or rubbishy papers or anything else do want it, who cares?
Yeah.
He knew he was himself as God made him.
Do you think he was closer to God than he let on?
It's difficult to answer that question because I'm not God. But in my judgment, he was closer to God than he realized.
Mm.
And God of the Bible, Jesus of the Bible, would have loved Terry Wogan.
Do you think that he is in heaven then?
If he's not, I don't want to be there, because I'd like to be where he is, because that's where goodness is.
May the Lord rise to meet you, may the wind be ever at your back, may the sun shine warm upon your face, and the rain fall soft upon your feet, and until we meet again. May God hold you, ever in the palm of his hand.
We'll be continuing our tribute to Sir Terry Wogan at the end of the programme with a musical performance recorded for children in need. But now, some music from the Salvation Army.
Thank you.
heads north to Scotland for the story of a worldwide charity which feeds a million of the world's poorest children every day. Here in the remote village of Dalmally in the west of Scotland, Callum and Mary Ann McFarland Barrow established a Catholic retreat centre in 1990, complete with an outdoor Stations of the Cross. In 2002, their son Magnus took over a shed round the back and established Mary's Meals.
So we found ourselves in Malawi working in these villages where people were literally starving. People were eating the roots of trees and the leaves of trees to survive. And I met this family, and the father of the family had died just before I met them, and the mother was now dying also. She was called Emma, and she had her six children around her. And I began talking to her oldest child. He was called Edward. He was about 14 years of age. And at one point in the conversation, I said, Edward, what are your hopes? What are your ambitions? And he said to me, I'd like to have enough food to eat, and I would like to be able to go to school one day. Mary's Meals is just this very simple thing. We provide one good meal every day in a place of education for the world's poorest children. We're serving those meals in a way that enables those children to come into school for the first time, where they can gain that education that sets them free.
How many of you feel that if there'll be no food in school, you will go to the street?
One of the keys to this model of Mary's Meals and why it works so well is that first and foremost it's owned by the local community. All of the daily work of cooking and serving the meals is carried out by local volunteers.
Good morning, Mary's Meals.
Mary's Meals has a small staff, some in Glasgow and some in another shed right next door to the Global HQ. But its strength is the army of highly motivated volunteers, those who work with the raw materials the charity supplies to serve the food throughout the world. And those who work in charity shops all over Scotland, such as this one in nearby Oban.
One of the reasons why I've chosen to stay rooted here is because I think it's really important to stay grounded. It's the reason why we've kept our global HQ in this little shed that I borrowed off my father all these years ago. More than anything, we feel we've really just begun. You know, there are another 59 million children who are out of school because of hunger. So I kind of feel at this stage what we've done is we've developed this very simple model that works. But we believe that every child in the world can receive a meal every day in their place of education. And that's possible in this world of plenty.
Like for our joy, like we could give.
Your people to care for your own.